good evening, everybody, and thank you for joining us. This is Common Ground Radio on Talk Shoe. We are a Days of Our Life discussion show where we dish on all the latest in Salem, USA. I am your host, Brandon, and on the line with us, as always, is my co-host, Misty.
Hello, guys.
So, you had a pretty busy week?
Yes, it was very busy with work, but I'm excited. We're off tomorrow. No work tomorrow. So that makes me a little bit happy.
It was my first week back of classes, and then I get a day off on Monday, so I can't really complain.
Yes. So was your week good for school?
Well, you know, the first week back is always kind of a little hectic, you know, getting your schedule arranged. And I had to redo my schedule a couple times, and, you know, you got financial aid problems and everything. But I think I have it all straightened out. So hopefully it's smooth sailing for the next, 14 weeks and finals week.
Yay! Fun.
Then one more semester, and then I'll be out of there.
That's awesome.
So, let's see. So, start off with a little preview of what we're going to discuss with in regards to last week's shows. So, last week on Days, Will is a little upset as to what he sees when he arrives home. Sammy, her chances at getting released begin to fade, but is she ready to make a deal? Brady has a very important question for Kristen, and I can't say this last part without laughing. I have to say I copied this this exact quote from one of the Days posts. They have that, you know, they have that Salem Style magazine thing that they post on the weekend.
I love that.
I would so buy that if I was out on the stand. And Sonny
the
finds an extra
large surprise
problem in the living room. Yeah. I guess
I knew that's where you were going. I knew that. That was hilarious. I was like, oh, extra large, hun. I wonder if you had to get it so easily.
That was my exact thought. I was like, no wonder, Gabby. Yeah. I think we'll just leave it at that. I think everyone knows what that means. Well, we all know now. I mean, never really understood what Gabby's attraction was, but I guess we know now.
Exactly.
This week, Misty had Monday, Wednesday, and Friday shows, so let's jump right into Monday show with Misty.
All right. Let's see. I guess I will start off with Sammy and EJ. Huh, imagine that.
Of course.
Imagine that, right? Okay. Mm-hmm. So, EJ, I guess on Friday's episode, she had, you know, made a statement about she wasn't sure if she's going to be able to go with the trial. So when Monday started, EJ was still kind of concerned about that statement that she had made. But she kept saying that she didn't mean what it sounded like, that she just wasn't sure she was going to be able to survive, let alone actually win the trial. So EJ was about to question her further when Kristen showed up. And she said, things are always darkest just before the dawn. Which at first I wasn't sure if Sammy was happy to see her, but then she kind of looked relieved a little bit to see her, and we found out why. Because when is Sammy ever excited to see Kristen?
Not really. Never.
But so EJ, he was about to ask Kristen to leave, but Sammy was like, no, actually, I need you to go and get me some shoes because EJ brought me the wrong shoes. He obviously can't tell the difference between cream and nude collar shoes. Which
I mean,
what's the
difference between cream and nude collar? I mean, come on, it's pretty simple, right?
I mean, hello. So she asked if they could actually go and get the shoes that she wanted, and she gave a specific type of shoe, something with a gold line around them or whatever, the nude shoes with the gold trim for her dress. And so he was trying to say that, you know, they needed to talk and finish their conversation, but she wanted EJ to leave so that she could talk to Justin privately. And she wanted to know about the jury selection that was going to be happening later that day. And then he finally agreed to leave with Kristen, and Sammy asked Justin if he believed that they could convince Melinda to offer a better deal like a shorter time served instead of the 10 years that she's wanting her to do for this deal. And he didn't seem like, you know, he was doubtful that she would change the deal. So he told her, you know, really, you just have to be willing to portray EJ so that they could ultimately take down Stefano. And he wondered if she would actually do that and how EJ would actually react to her betrayal.
EJ said he'd do anything for
her. He would, but he was not very happy when he finds out about all this.
Mm-hmm.
So they keep talking back and forth about the deal or whatever. And meanwhile, EJ is at the mansion with Kristen, and she's trying to find the shoes, or she finds the shoes that Sammy wants her to get. And he said that he wasn't, or she said, I think they call it robbery, blackmail, and intimidation. But EJ claimed that he wasn't doing anything and that he didn't know what she was talking about. And because she said that he seemed very pessimistic, Sammy seems pessimistic, but EJ seems optimistic. And then that's when she said that little quote. Kristen was skeptical of him and reminded that the Demiras need to stack the deck to make sure that they would always win. And she was concerned that EJ might do something stupid that would either cause him to get charged with criminal conspiracy or leave an opening for Stefano to strike back. But he said he had the situation under control. So trying to change the subject, he brought up her relationship with Brady. And she said that they were happily reunited and everything was perfect. Of course, he didn't seem too convinced with that. Then Dustin returned back to the cell. I guess he had left, and he came back to the cell as Roman was telling Sammy to remain positive. And then a short time later, EJ came back with her requested pair of shoes and some photographs of the kids. He also brought her some tape so that she could hang them in the wall in her cell. She seemed a little bit happy, but she still didn't look too, you know, he could tell that she was still, that something was wrong with her.
In a normal jail cell, you wouldn't be able to have visitors like 24/7.
I know.
Because she's never alone. Not very realistic, if you ask me.
Yeah.
But what in Salem is realistic?
Yeah. Nothing. No one ever really dies in Salem either. But anyway, so a guard comes and announced that Justin needed to get to the courthouse. So that is where the EJ Sammy storyline was for Monday. Also, something that happened in regards to that storyline was Adrian talked to Roman a little bit, and Roman pretty much told her that he wished that she hadn't done what she had done.
She thought that he'd understand, but she thought wrong.
Yeah, definitely. Definitely thought wrong. More stuff on Monday was JJ. He was, like, completely taken back when he opened up Daniel's apartment door and saw them kissing. he actually looked disgusted. I believe he called her a slut.
He did. Those exact words came out of his mouth. And Daniel didn't take to that too kindly.
No, he actually grabbed him up by his shirt, and I was like, uh-oh. I wasn't sure how Jennifer was going to react to that. So he's like, don't you ever speak to your mother like that again. And, of course, JJ looked terrified.
I would be,
Jennifer.
Too. If there's a big orange monster coming towards me trying to pin me against the wall.
I was like, oh, gosh, what is happening? But, so he completely went off the handle. And
Jennifer wasn't too upset with JJ. She wasn't too upset with JJ for what he said, which kind of surprised me.
Right. She got mad at Daniel for, I guess, telling her, because she said she could handle it, that she didn't need him to jump in or whatever.
Mm-hmm.
Like, obviously, you can't handle it.
No.
So I was like,
she has no idea what's going on with her son right now.
I mean, he said we were just kissing. It's not like she walked in on something, you know, worthy of him calling her a slut.
Right.
I mean, they weren't It's not like they were naked on the couch or something. So, but anyway, he clearly can't handle Daniel. I don't think that he doesn't like Daniel. I just think that he doesn't want Jennifer with anybody else. Like, nobody's going to be able to replace Jack.
Yeah, he doesn't want anyone to replace Jack, and that's what he thinks Daniel is trying to do, which he's not, but that's what JJ thinks.
Right. So part of me kind of feels bad for him, but then the other part of me doesn't, because I'm like, you're acting like a spoiled brat. But, I mean, whatever. So something else on Monday was Will and Sonny, and they got the phone call about or I guess they had gotten their slips of paper to testify against Sammy, and they were waiting to talk to Justin. So Justin met them at the club to talk about their legal rights and gave them both an attorney that they could each call, two different attorneys, so that Will would have one and Sonny would have one. So they were supposed to call them that they had to have Gabby miss school so that they could go meet Justin, which made Gabby angry. Because she said she already had to miss the club opening, and now she's got to miss classes. And I'm like, really?
Oh,
get your priorities together. I'm like, you have a daughter. Get your priorities together. You didn't even really need to go to that club opening.
The club's going to be there forever anyways.
Right. Right. So they were mad. And then Adrian showed up at the club, and Justin pretty much dismissed her. So kind of like, get out, I have to talk to them for a minute. And she didn't leave, of course. She waited outside.
She has no one in town. Kind of sad, and it's not funny at the same time.
No. Whatever. But Nick showed up at the club and was kind of like going up to Will and was like, yay, congratulations on the renovation of the coffee house. Trying to be all sweet and nice. And Will kind of just looked at him like, really?
Whatever, yeah.
Yeah. And then he kind of brought up, you know, that he had paid for his prior convictions, but what about what he had done since he'd been out, kind of thing, kind of asked him, you know, have you really changed or whatever. Let's see. I think that's about it, except for Nick ended up going to the apartment, and it was holding the baby.
Yeah, I want to get into that with Tuesdays.
Yeah, okay. And then the only thing that, how it ended was, she said, you and your boyfriend need to start remembering that, meaning that Ariana is her baby too. So she can have, I guess, whoever she wants around them. So that was pretty much Monday.
And then that was not her place. She
right.
was offered
She's staying
to
there.
Live there.
Yes.
Mm-hmm, exactly. Well, I don't know. you know that we're not a fashion show, but we always talk about people's clothes and what they wear and, you know, hair and whatnot. What about her pants?
Oh, my gosh.
Gabby's
don't
pants.
Even get me started on that. That was the first thing I said when she walked in on the scene. I was like, what are you wearing? I was like, oh, my gosh. And it looked like a workout tank top.
Yeah.
And then he's like, pajama bottoms. I don't know. I have no idea.
The funny thing about that was, I can't remember if it was this week or this past week or the week before, but Camilla Bannis, who portrays Gabby, live tweeted Days one day. And I asked her a question and she responded. I asked her, I said, do you ever get to pick out the clothes that Gabby gets to wear? Because I complimented her on the dress that she had on the night of the club opening that she didn't get to go to. And she was like,
that was nice.
Yeah. I thought that was nice. Well, but she responded to me and she said that she does. She said she has a very huge impact on what Gabby wears. She has a huge say in what Gabby wears. I was like, oh. And this was before, I think, her whole outfit this week. So
I guess this speaks to
her style.
Yeah. I kind of thought she did have her say in her clothes because I know her favorite color is purple, and she wears purple a lot. And her eyeshadow, you know, she wears a lot of purple. So I thought, I wonder if she actually gets to do that. That's hilarious. Why would she choose that? I have no idea. Crazy.
Oh, my God. I don't have that kind of fashion sense, so I wouldn't know.
Her earrings are cute, but
oh my. So we'll get right into Tuesday's show. See what I want to. I think we had Kristen and Daniel scenes. We had some Brady and Jennifer scenes. We had very emotional, very moving Nicole and Eric scenes, which I want to discuss. And a continuation of the Will and Sonny Gabby stuff from Monday. I don't know. Maybe I'll just run through the whole thing. I don't know. We'll just see how this goes. I'll start out with Nicole and Eric. So the show starts out with Nicole coming into one of the hospital rooms in the Salem Hospital. Eric is there. Eric had spent the night with a dying patient. I think her name was, I don't know if it was Elizabeth or Lizbeth or something like that.
I didn't catch her name.
Yeah, I think it was on the credits, but I don't pay attention to credits, so I don't know what it was. I found her on Twitter. Well, actually, she found me, which is a funny thing. I tweeted about how she did a good job. I mean, I didn't know what the actress's name was, but I just tweeted about news, you know, hashtag days, and she responded to me and said thank you. So,
that's cool.
Yeah, she's very sweet. I think her name is Amanda Ardsmith or Ardsmith. I don't know. But we'll probably never want to see her back considering her character died. But I'll have to try to find her Twitter handle, and I'll post that on our Twitter and Facebook page in case you'd like to follow her. So Elizabeth asked Nicole to stay with her since apparently she looks so much like her sister. Eric assures her that he and Nicole will both stay with her. Nicole talks to her, and Eric delivers the woman her last rites. And shortly thereafter, she passed away. Her sister was on her way, but her sister did not arrive by the time she had passed. So her sister had arrived, and she wanted a few moments alone with her sister. So Eric and Nicole left and went outside of the hospital room. And, Eric told the sister that she had passed in peace, and she had made peace with what was about to happen. Like I said, Nicole and Eric stepped out, and Eric said that Elizabeth is in God's loving arms. Just to elaborate on that scene, it was just very, it kind of wasn't expecting, it kind of just popped up in the middle of the week on Tuesday. But, you know, we didn't have any, we weren't alluded to anything like this, and it was just, I very much enjoyed the scenes because it's just, you know, there was something that we weren't expecting, first of all, and then I just thought that everyone in the scene, the actors, Ari Zucker and Greg Vaughn and Amanda, all three did an amazing job. I'd like to discuss more of Nicole and Eric, and I believe they had gone, did they go to the pub?
Yeah.
They went to the pub, and Nicole told Eric that all he does is give to others. And she asked him, don't you deserve a little happiness yourself? Eric tells Nicole that he's happy. I believe you can, the look on his face, I wouldn't say he looks depressed or upset, but he looks tired. And, well, we all know that he is tired after staying up all night with this parishioner in the hospital. He acknowledges that things were difficult for him when he decided to become a priest, and he still has some doubts. Eric says that he was haunted for a very long time by the Congo, the incident in Congo, I believe. We found out about that around Christmas time last year. He opened up about that,
mm-hmm.
What happened when he was in Congo. Nicole helped. Wait, was it Nicole? Nicole just they continued talking. Nicole apologizes for doubting his choice in becoming a priest. They return back to the rectory, and Nicole takes Eric's phone and tells him to go get some rest, which is easier said than done for Eric with what he's going through right now. Daniel arrives at the rectory wanting to talk with Eric, but Nicole says that he is resting. They switch to the bed to show Eric, and he snaps awake while dreaming about the night that he spent with Kristen. Of course, he doesn't know that it's Kristen, but he is dreaming of that night that happened. So he remembers the night that he was, I'm going to say, unfaithful, I guess, so to speak. But I guess he doesn't really know. He doesn't really know if it's real or not. He just thinks that God's trying to tell him something.
Mm-hmm.
I think it might be later in the week that he calls a bishop or he talks to Father Matt about what is going on with his dreams. So I think I'll get back in or jump backwards a little bit to the beginning of the episode and get back into the Will and Gabby argument, and then Sonny arrived also. So at the apartment, Gabby and Will continue to argue very heatedly about Nick, because when Will arrived home, he saw Nick holding his daughter. Will didn't take too kindly to that, of course. So Gabby and Will were arguing about that, and Sonny had just arrived, and he warns them that Ari can hear them because he could hear them when he was outside the door. And this gets Gabby even more upset because she feels like Sonny is trying to tell her how to be a mother.
Mm-hmm.
So then she walked away and walked into Ari's bedroom and shut the door. So she probably woke up her daughter right there. But anyways, she wonders what happened. Gabby wonders what happened to it being all three of them together in this whole situation together. And they say, Will and Sonny say that they are together, they're with her, but they don't think, Will especially, doesn't think that Nick is the person that Gabby should be with. Sonny asks what started this whole argument, and then arguing about Nick again. They disagree on whether Nick has changed, and I believe that most Dave fans can argue over this, whether Nick has changed. I'm sure it's probably split as to what fans think, if he's changed or not. So they get nowhere with this conversation, and Gabby just storms out. So luckily there are people there to watch Ariana. She didn't just leave her alone, which I kind of fully expected, but she didn't. Will and Sonny discuss the situation, and Will says that he will never trust Nick again. I believe I missed some things in here, but the argument that Will and Sonny and Gabby had, Gabby said, I'm not going to have this completely exactly how she said it, but she said that Nick said he was sorry. And Will isn't sure how to respond to that. And he just basically says that sorry okay, that's great and everything, but sorry doesn't help or it doesn't make up for everything that he had done to me and done to Sonny, because you know what he called Sonny earlier. And then Gabby said that Nick has been through a lot, so she's basically trying to make an excuse for his actions. And then Will counteracted that statement by Gabby by saying, and Sonny and I haven't been through a lot, and Gabby isn't sure how to respond to that, because obviously what Sonny and Will, especially Will, have been through a lot in the past year. So like I said, they reached an impasse, and Gabby just decided to leave the house, apartment. Sonny, after all this, Sonny tells Will that they should bend a little for Gabby. Will marvels at Sonny's endless understanding, because he can't get past what Nick has done. He wonders how long it'll take to work out, and Sonny reassures him that he'll do whatever he can to make it work. But they have to realize that it's not easy for Gabby. Will just hopes that she opens her eyes about Nick. And of course, as they are talking about this, Gabby is in the town square having a study session with Nick. So, obviously, she didn't open her eyes that much. So, other things that happened on Tuesday that I'm not going to go into big detail with. Brady and Jennifer had a discussion. Brady came over, and I believe, was he looking for Daniel or Kristen? I think he was looking for Kristen.
Mm-hmm.
Jennifer was crying, so Brady was there to comfort her and tell her that you shouldn't give up on Daniel. Brady and Kristen are both the Danifer shipper. which I'm sure upsets many fans. Not this one, but I'm sure many fans it upset. Then at Daniel's place, Kristen is there, and they get into a little heated argument, but they calm down, and they begin to discuss Jennifer. Kristen is trying to push Daniel to go see Jennifer. Later, Maggie came over to Daniel's, of course, because she wanted to be in the middle of everything, like she always does. And like I said, Nick helped Gabby with her homework in the town square. Later, Kristen came over to the Horton house to talk with Jennifer and try to tell her, just like she had told Daniel, to talk with each other. She really loves Daniel and Jennifer together. She thinks they're perfect for each other. Kristen insists that she goes to see Daniel because Daniel has good news. And that good news, which I forgot to mention, was that he received the birth certificate of Parker that has his name on the birth certificate. So Philip's name is off the birth certificate, and Daniel's name is finally on it. Jen leaves living room, and Kristen is getting ready to leave the house. Then she turns around. Well, Brady sneaks up behind her and kisses her. I think that continued into Wednesday's show. But that is all, everything that had happened on Tuesday's show. So, all right.
Monday and Wednesday and Friday were awesome for me because they're all jammy days. Okay, sorry. I get to talk about them. Okay, let's see. Wednesday, there was quite a bit of little storylines going on. But let's get started with this. Okay, so Sammy said that she wanted the jury selection, or she wished that the jury selection had taken longer, because it was nice to be out of her cell for a little while. And I didn't ever see her out of the cell. Did you?
I don't remember. No, she was I remember seeing her dressed up, but I don't remember seeing her out of the cell, personally.
Because I was like,
it must have happened off screen.
Okay. It must have just been, yeah, like you said, behind the scenes.
Mm-hmm.
So she had asked Justin, or he said that, you know, they've made their decision on the jury, and that jury expert predicted that it was 80% chance of being convicted. So she was not very happy about that. She wanted to be alone. So Justin and EJ left, and they went back to the Demure mansion. EJ said that Justin shouldn't be so negative in front of Sammy because she's going to stop fighting for herself. And then Justin said that Sammy had to, all she had to do was tell the truth and leave the fighting to him. And then EJ said, she's going to beat this, I know it. So then EJ, or Justin kind of was like, why do you seem so certain about this? And then he also brought up the point, why was he so sure that they was going to find some incriminating evidence in Bernardi's house? And he said, because he's a corrupt cop. And then Justin believed that EJ had planted something for the police to find. And he was, you know, not going along with that. And then he said, I'm starting to wonder if maybe what you really want is to make sure that she's found guilty. Justin said that to EJ. And then EJ was kind of like, why would you say that? Kind of taken aback by it. And he said that he would never do anything to jeopardize Sammy's chances of being acquitted. And then Justin warned him that if evidence of Bernardi showed up somehow, then they would try to find out, you know, if it was falsified. And then falsified evidence that in order to clear a cop killer, and she was going to make sure the judge and the jury think that Sammy was in on it so that she would get to spend the rest of her life in prison. Abe stopped by to see Sammy, and he told her, you know, that he believed her, that she really did kill him to protect Ray. And she said that she was really glad that he said that because she wanted somebody besides EJ and to know that she did it to save Ray. then she called for the guard when Abe left and said that she wanted to talk to the special prosecutor. And so she showed up with her assistant and said that he was there to serve as a witness for the conversation because they had to have something, somebody else besides the two of them. And then she turned on, I guess it was a recorder, and told her, you know, to say her name or whatever, and that she was asked to see her without counsel present, and that, and then Sammy said, I want to make a deal, and I screamed at the TV. Let's see. I was like, no, Sammy, you don't want to make a deal. Okay, that was my little dramatization of what happened.
Did you really think that she was going to give up EJ? Because I was reading Twitter, and I saw a ton of EJ fans that actually were worried that she was actually going to give up EJ. I never actually thought that she would really do it. But,
well, see, I thought she would for her kids. Okay, as a mother, I would probably throw him under the bus. No, I'm just kidding.
I figured she had some kind of plan.
Yeah, but I'm glad that she didn't. So, anyway, as of Wednesday, I thought she was going to, and I was like, no. So, anyway, that was all that story. Also on Wednesday, Cameron, or I guess Abe ran into Cameron, thanked him for taking Theo to a baseball game. And then they talked a little bit about Lexi. And then Abigail went by Club TPD. She lost her necklace there from the night before, and Chad had found it and fixed the clasp because it had broken, and she explained that Jack had given her that necklace, and so she was very, very happy to find it. And then they start kissing, and
how sweet.
Cameron sees them, and he, like, takes off like a crazy man, just, like, runs away. She goes chasing after him. He says he's late for an appointment, and she's like, you know, why are you just, like, pretty much giving Chad to me?
Abigail, it's about darn time you pick someone. How long has she had these guys on a leash? How long has she been torturing
them? A while.
She drives me nuts. She's also pretty boring, yeah, me too, so I think she should just be with Cameron because they make a pretty boring, perfect couple.
Yeah.
But I also like Cameron and Gabby, too.
I know, me too. So we'll see what happens with that. But probably nothing. Because Gabby's going to hook back up with Nick. Okay. Some other stuff from Wednesday was JJ and Rory and Bev were in the park, and JJ got his first on-screen kiss, didn't he? Was that the first time?
I think that was his first, yep.
Uh-oh. And her ex-boyfriend, Cole, saw it and was not very happy about it. Kind of made me think that he's probably going to turn him in because he said something like...
He has crazy eyes.
I know. He looks creepy. So he was like, he's going to pay for that one. So I'm wondering if he's going to, like, turn him in or something. Because he obviously knows what they're doing.
You'll see in the previews for next week.
Uh-oh. Dun, dun, dun. And then there was a little bit more of Jennifer talking to JJ, saying that they needed to talk. Daniel went to actually see Eric. Eric, of course, was having his dream and didn't get any sleep. Nicole and Daniel had a little chit-chat. Their friendship's quite interesting. after everything that's gone on, and they're still, like, really close, which, whatever.
Yeah.
And then he showed the birth certificate to Eric. Eric suggested he go and see Jennifer, which he does. Also, Brady wanted to take Kristen to Kauai, I think. And she was like, she can't because she's still doing the scholarship interviews. And then Eric called, I guess, Father Matt, and that's when he told him about the dream. And then he looked up and saw Kristen was waving at him from the doorway, and so he got off of the phone. But he kept saying that he thinks God's trying to tell him something, or God's speaking to me, but he doesn't know what he's trying to say. So that's pretty much Wednesday.
I have something I was going to say right there, but I'll just keep that to myself in reference to Eric.
Uh-oh.
This wouldn't be appropriate, so. Let's see. So Thursdays. Oh, crap, the NASCAR race is starting. I'll catch it later. Sorry. I'm trying to multitask here. Thursday.
We're doing good with time tonight, too. We're already on Thursday.
I know. Yeah, right. It shouldn't take me long, too, either, so. I just watched Thursdays again, so hopefully this is fresh in my mind, but it probably isn't. I probably just forgot everything, so it's a good thing I have some notes up here. Well, we had Abigail, Cameron, Chad. I don't even want to get into that because it's not even worth it. We also had more Daniel and Jennifer, which I know everybody hates, so maybe I'll talk about that just to make everyone mad. We also had some Teresa scenes. Nicole met with Brady in the square. Kristen appeared in Eric's office. EJ and the accountant had a little discussion. Sammy and Melinda. I'm trying to see what I want to discuss in depth. I think I'll talk about, since Daniel and Jennifer scenes were a majority of the show that day. Actually, they were on a majority of the week. I might as well discuss them. At the Horton house, Daniel offers to leave because he had come over to talk with Jennifer. JJ was there. JJ tells Jennifer that it's her call as to whether she wants to talk to him or Daniel. And Jennifer elects to speak with Daniel. And JJ snarks that he knows where he stands, Jennifer. This kid needs to learn the totem pole in the family. He's such a troubled individual. I kind of feel bad for, like you, I kind of feel bad for him. I probably don't have as much empathy for him as you do, but
if he wasn't so cute, I wouldn't. Just kidding.
Oh, okay. I see how it is. So Jennifer elected to speak with Daniel, and JJ decided to leave. Well, I think Jennifer told him to go finish a book report at the library or whatever. So Jennifer and Daniel go into the living room, and Daniel shows Jennifer the birth certificate of Parker with his name on it. He explains that it made him realize that he has been unfair to Jennifer in the past, meaning how how blunt he was with Jennifer about how she is raising JJ, how she is treating him, so to speak. Jennifer, Daniel says that he loves her enough to step away because of JJ. Jennifer sniffles that JJ just needs more time to accept another man in her life. But every time that Jennifer and Daniel have a little misunderstanding, this is what Jennifer says. Jennifer always says that he just needs a little more time. JJ just needs a little more time. A little more time. How much time are you going to give the kid? He's almost 20. Well, I mean, actually, I think he's like 19, so I'm assuming. He's old enough to not have to, well, no kid should be controlling their parents' love life to begin with. But he needs to butt out and grow up is basically what I think. I don't know. Maybe I'm just mean. I'm so lost. Where was I? Just completely lost my train of thought. Hold on, everyone. I'm sorry.
You're not reading the chat room right now, because then you really would be distracted.
No, I have like five things up here at once. Do I even want to read the chat room? I probably don't.
No.
Travis.
Say on the air.
Okay. Oh, my Lord. Just stop, Travis. Just stop. So
you're on the bridge to proposal, I think, is what guest
said. Okay. Let's get back into days, which is what we are about. Daniel tells Jennifer that he cannot keep doing things the way that they are doing things. They need to live in reality. He says that he loves her and he leaves. So this seems to be Jennifer breakup number 675. But I'm sure it won't be the last. I have to say, last week wasn't all that interesting to me. There wasn't that many. I don't know. It just didn't.
It wasn't exciting. It was sad.
No.
And depressing.
Well, yeah. And a lot of Daniel and Jennifer, which makes people upset. We finally saw Teresa last week. She hadn't been on for a while, and she was on Thursday. I think Thursday was her only day on. I'll talk a little bit about her. Teresa chastises herself at the hospital. She's there working. Well, she's not working, but she's in the office. I figure that's where Teresa was always because we saw Jennifer was out of the office. You know, she was in town or in the Horton in her house.
Mm-hmm.
But I figured that Teresa was probably there doing all the work. You know, in quotations, doing all the work.
Yeah, shoe shopping, that's hard work.
Online shopping, yep. She's going to run out of all the money that she stole from Vargas. She's talking to herself. She says that she's going to run out of all that money if she keeps shopping. So she sets off the computer, and then right as she does that, Roman shows up. Uncle Roman, right? I think it's her uncle. He gives her a warning about hanging out with a convicted felon. He reminds her that she's not here to have fun. He really lays into Teresa. He just ends things by saying, "Grow up, Teresa." She could, you know, grow up. But I don't see that happening unless that would happen come November when some major people in her life. I have some casting news to tell you guys in case you didn't know coming up at the end of the show. I think I'll get into the Sammy things. I'll end Thursdays with that. Melinda Trask, the special prosecutor, is at Sammy's cell. Sammy says she's ready to make a deal. She tells Sammy that she'll do only 10 years if she gives her EJ. Sammy scoffs. She offers to give her Stefano. Melinda wonders how she'd do that. Sammy admits that she has nothing on Stefano, but she offers up EJ again, holding out for a better deal. Melinda comes back with possible parole after 5 years if EJ gives her Stefano. Sammy wants it in writing, plus she wants immunity for Will. Of course, Melinda doesn't seem like she wants that. She doesn't seem too enthused about this newly revised deal. Sammy adds that if she can get her Stefano directly, she wants a maximum of 5 years. Later, EJ arrives. This is after Melinda had already left. And Sammy says that Melinda had offered her 5 years for enough information to put Stefano behind bars. And EJ was kind of taken aback and was a little upset when he heard this. EJ says that she doesn't have anything on Stefano. Sammy says, "But you do. She may have to give him to Trask," is what Sammy said. And as we all know, even though EJ said that he would do anything for Sammy, apparently this was not one of the things that he would do. So the very last thing, I'll just end with the very last thing that happened on Thursday's show. Nicole knocked on Eric's bedroom door, and he was awakened from another dream about the night that he spent with Kristen. I believe on Friday's I don't think Nicole gets into the bedroom. I don't think Eric allowed her to come in.
No.
Because he wasn't fully clothed, so I don't think Eric would allow her to see him like he was. even though, you know, she had in the past because, you know, they had a thing at one time. that was everything that happened on Thursday's days.
I'm going to finish off the Sammy storyline with Friday, starting out that. Let's see. So Sammy outlined the terms of her deal with Melinda for EJ. If Sammy could produce incriminating evidence against Stefano, which she hoped EJ would give to her, she would only have to spend 5 years in prison. If EJ couldn't do that, Sammy had to give him something on EJ, or give her something on EJ. While EJ was looking at her like he could absolutely kill her, she expressed to EJ that he wouldn't have to spend any time behind bars because he could work out a deal for complete immunity by giving them something on Stefano. And he kept looking at her like he could seriously burn her with his eyes. And so she turns around and was like, I just can't spend the rest of my life in prison. And then he was like, oh, but I can. Like, he's furious, you can tell. He couldn't believe that Sammy was naive and stupid enough to believe that he could ever get immunity. She argued with him about some guy in New York had just cut a deal, even though he had killed a lot of people. And I was like, what?
You're paying more attention than I was, because I don't even remember that.
And he was like, he was a soldier. My name is Demira. They will never let me walk. And I tweeted that part because I was like, yeah, he's true. It's true. I mean, he's a Demira. But they get him, they're going to keep him. I was like, no. And then she begged EJ to give her something on Stefano that she could give to the special prosecutor. She was screaming, help me. And he was like, what do you think I'm trying to do? And she said, this is the only lifeboat in sight. It is the only deal. If you won't let me give him Stefano, then you will have to. And they were arguing back and forth. And she said she would get out after 5 years. Well, he would probably get a much longer sentence. And then he wanted to know when she decided to go that route. And she said, you heard what Justin and that expert said about jury selection. I don't have a chance at trial. And then she explained that the initial deal was lousy, but she had given it a lot of thought, and she knew that she couldn't spend the rest of her life in prison. She said she can't do that to the kids. She just can't. And then EJ said, you talk about how we're together in this, but we're not. I'm in here all by myself. I'm in this cage all by myself. What am I supposed to do? She said that to EJ. And then she stretched her hand out through the bars, and he was acting like, you know, he didn't want anything to do with her. And she said, I miss the kids every minute, but I ache for you. And
see, at this point, if they were at home, this is the point where EJ would have slammed Sammy against the wall and jammed his tongue down her throat. But since she is behind bars, they cannot do that.
Right. Mm-hmm. Exactly. She's like, I know you love me, even right now. She wanted him to tell her that he loved her. So finally he turns around and he says, I love you. And, of course, I'm sitting there like, oh, this is so sweet. And then he's like, sweetheart, there's just one small problem. You can't give me up to the special prosecutor because you don't have anything to give. And that he had that little EJ look on his face. And at first I was like, EJ. And then she said, you kidnapped Sydney. And I was like, oh, no, really, Samantha? Why are you going to bring that up?
Oh, snap.
I know. And then he said,
I think we need to censor Travis in the chat room.
Oh, no. What's he doing now?
This isn't about nothing, but...
I just had to interrupt. And I have no idea.
Oh, my Lord.
Oh, Travis. So anyway, they go back and forth or whatever. And Melinda shows up. And then EJ went and leave, and she says, do we have a deal or not? And she's kind of snarky. I don't really like her.
She always is. That's her personality.
I don't know. But I'm like, really? And then Sammy says, take your deal and shove it. Which, I love that. I was like, yes! I wasn't screaming at the TV anymore. I was very happy. And then she said, Melinda said to Sammy, that soon all she'll have of her children were those photos, so she would never get to touch them again or something like that.
She's so heartless, too.
I know. She's mean.
She must not have a family.
No.
She must not have a man either. I mean, it's pretty obvious she doesn't have a man.
Yeah, I was like, she's single. She has to be. And then they start talking about how they have to make Bernardi, you know, all his dirt come up or whatever. And so Sammy kind of suggested, you know, let's say some evidence just turned up. And then EJ told her no, because if it was seen that it was planted, it would be worse for her. And then he comes back and he's like holding her through the jail cell or whatever. He says, soon they'll be together, that he'll get her out, the kids and you. And then she says, yes, better believe that, EJ assured her. So he's pretty much telling her he's going to find a way, no matter what it takes, to get her out. Because he loves her that much. I'm so glad she didn't turn him in. Okay, so some more stuff that happened on Friday was Brady. He went to like that secluded park area in the park that everybody seems to go to, and he made an Hawaiian paradise.
Mm-hmm.
So, of course, Kristen was like, you know, shocked or whatever. Didn't believe it. And then what was it that she had that, was it on a piece of paper or on a
piece of cardboard? It was in a bottle.
The bottle, okay.
Piece of paper in a bottle, yeah.
Okay, because I was like, I missed something, and I don't remember what it was. I didn't rewind it, but it said, will you marry me?
Will you marry me, Kristen?
Marry me, Kristen.
I think that might have been on Thursday, so I probably should have brought that up.
Oh, it's all
right. I
think
that carried into Friday.
And so, of course, she's looking at him like he's completely crazy, which I thought was funny because the look on her face is just like, are you serious right now?
She looked scared.
I know. She looked like she didn't know what to say or what to do. And then he says, there's going to be many of these moments coming soon. Just help a guy out. Like, he's wanting her to answer him. And she says, okay, yes. And then she says yes again. And then he's like, okay, just keep saying yes, everything that he asks. And he asks about his shirt, which I thought was hilarious.
I bet Eric probably took that out of his cell or something. It's hilarious.
Because that shirt was hilarious. And then they just, you know, kiss or whatever. And she put the ring on, and yay, they're engaged. And then
Ring put a ring on it.
Yep, he put a ring on it. And then Victor and Marlena are talking. And what did Marlena? Wait, it was on Friday, wasn't it, when Marlena asked Roman?
Yep.
Okay, yeah. So Marlena met with Roman and wanted him to get phone records. And he said they couldn't right now legally because, you know, he's not on the force right now. And so that didn't seem to make her sad in any way. She's still going to go forward and try to do whatever she can with Kristen. And then she shows up at the Demira mansion. And she's like, EJ's not here. And she's like, oh, good, because I'm here to see you. And so she's there to see Kristen. And then also on Friday, Sunny and Will talk about how somebody needs to give Nick a chance. Because, you know, if he's trying to not be a bigot or whatever, then somebody needs to give him a chance. And Sunny said, well, you're a better man than me. And then Gabby was with Nick still doing their calculus studying or whatever. Then they break up. What did you say?
Calculus isn't easy. I took it in high school, and I tell you, it was a lot harder than some of the college math I took. But anyways, just I had to throw that out there.
Well, Nick's
I didn't take calculus.
Don't forget, he's like a mad scientist.
Working
in the hospital, scientist thing.
Mm-hmm.
The little lab or whatever. That's before he went crazy the first time. So he wasn't a mad scientist until the end. But anyway, and they talk or whatever, and Will pretty much tells him at the pub that, no, he wasn't comfortable with him holding his daughter and that he didn't want her, didn't want him around her. And, you know, that somebody needs to give him a chance, but it's not going to be him. And I was like,
he just laid it all out there.
I know. I was like, tell it like it is. And then I think... Oh, yeah, this is when Eric was having another nightmare and Nicole knocked on the door. But he said he was fine to leave him alone. Mm. And then he ends up coming in there and they're looking for, it's funny because she's like, I can't get the mail merge to work. So she comes to get Nicole for that. And then she couldn't find keys. And so he finds that, I think, of matches. And
yeah, the sister was having a pretty bad day.
Yeah, she was, bless her heart. She's like, I can't get the numbers to work, and where are the keys? But, help me. But he wanted to know, you know, why they had the match, the matches were there or whatever. And she's like, she just grabbed everything from the hotel that night, and she really didn't want to talk about that time. And then Brady shows up and interrupts and tells him that he asked Kristen to marry him.
And Nicole wasn't too happy.
Oh, no. Oh, no. She knew what he was going to say before she said it. And Eric, of course, is oblivious like he always is. He's like, what are you talking about? What's going on?
That poor kid. That poor guy. Yeah, I think Nicole was like, she said like no like six times to Brady. No, 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 no.
And that before he could even say what happened. Oh, no.
Eric was completely confused.
I know. He's like, what's going on? Poor Eric. He's sleep deprived and he's clueless.
Which is exactly what someone in the chat room said. Brady is clueless, all capital letters. before, so that's everything from last week on Days of Our Lives.
Yes.
So... let me just look through the chat room here before I get into the spoilers and comings and goings and closing the show. Travis says that I think we need some, we should see Roman with a young love interest.
Roman and Gabby?
No,
ew.
No. Roman and Kate, I wouldn't be opposed.
Yeah, I mean, they were together before.
Yeah, that's true. So they got to connect. Well, I don't think they can handle each other right now, though.
I thought they were going to put Abe and Taylor together there for a while.
I did too. They probably planned on it, they just forgot about it.
Yeah, it might happen later. Or maybe they'll put Maxine with Abe.
Maxine, Kayla, and Abe. A triangle, a love triangle between all... Rosalind in the chat room said she was quoting Brady and Kristen here, which it was. I loved it. Do you love my shirt? Brady asked, and Kristen says yes. Brady says, do you love me? And Kristen says yes. And then Rosalind responded. She said, that shirt's hilarious, though. Cute but hilarious. It was.
Yeah, definitely.
Wouldn't be my first choice of attire, but yeah. Guest 5 says that they are looking forward to Nicole joining Victor and Marlene to bring down Kristen. Oh, is that a spoiler? Maybe we'll get into that here in a few seconds. Rosalind said that Roman and Marlene were going to be together. Yeah, I don't know. I kind of thought there back when John was still on the show that they were going to head that route. But I don't know.
Roman acted like he had feelings for her still and was all over John all the time.
I thought they were going to go that route, but right now it doesn't. It looks like Marlene's going to be spending the majority of her time with Victor, which I'm not sure how Maggie will take that. But kind of funny how Maggie's never around Marlene. Guest 5 says that Kayla needs. That was nice. He's available. I know Stephen Nichols, who played Steve, was on Young and the Restless, but he was fired from there. So he is available. If Days wants him, they want him bad enough.
I always like Travis, that. They should bring him back.
They, that kind of rhyme. Did you mean for that to rhyme? Travis says that Days needs to upgrade the kids and make a younger generation. I think soaps do Storys way too much. That soap opera, rapid aging syndrome, where they age kids, you know, like 10 years, which I've experienced this with Young and the Restless. With they have no children left on the show. I mean, all of their younger kids have been aged to teen to young 20s. All the kids that last year, I can remember some of them being, you know, like between 5 and 10, and now they're all between 15 and 20. But, you know, sometimes it works and sometimes it doesn't. But personally, I would like to see Days keep, you know, keep Johnny and Sydney and Allie, you know, young, I mean, for at least a while. And Sierra, I think they have to keep Sierra. Sierra is probably one of the best young little actresses that they have on the show. Next to the twins that play Ariana, of course.
Did you watch the show back when John and Marlena got married a long time ago and Brady and Sammy and Eric were tiny? And then I swear it wasn't like 2 weeks. They were teenagers. It's crazy.
Really?
I was like, oh, my gosh, they grew them up way too fast. And then that's when Allison Sweeney came into the picture and all that. But I was just like, that's crazy. Because you've seen a little flower girl and a little ring bear.
Mm-hmm.
And then I swear not even 2-3 weeks, they're teenagers. It might have been longer
crazy
than that, but that's what it felt like. I was like, this is crazy.
And it's funny how it, like, passes. Like, I mean, people don't really, I mean, it's kind of common on soaps to do that, so it's not really, like, a big deal. I mean, some people it's a big deal, but, I mean, to me, I'm used to it. So if it were to happen, I wouldn't be surprised, but, I mean, I think they should keep the younger generation young, I mean, as long as they can.
Mm-hmm.
So I think that's about it there in the chat room. So thank you to everybody in the chat room for giving us your thoughts. Right now, I'd like to get into the comings and goings and the spoilers for the week of September 2nd, which is next week. The only new coming and going that we have is, brace yourself, everybody, Charles Shaughnessy, who plays Shane, will return for a few episodes in November, just in time for November Sweep. And we already know that Patsy Peace will be returning in November, so Teresa's parents will be making a return to Salem, and I can only imagine what will be in store for Teresa when those two return. I'm sure it will not be good, but
I know Daddy's going to put her in her place.
She's going to be running scared.
And Kimberly's pretty feisty, too. She'll probably let her have it, too. She's kind of Kimberly and Shane.
I don't remember. I mean, I remember Shane from that explosion that was supposed to kill Bo and Hope and Marlena and John and Carrie and Ray. I remember Shane from then, but I wasn't watching when Kimberly was on, so this will be my first experience with Kimberly. Is her name Donovan, too, or does she? Are Kim and Shane still married? As far as we know?
I think so. I'm pretty sure. Yeah, I'm pretty
sure.
Anyone
in the chat room want to confirm? I was just curious. I wasn't sure if they were like, I mean, we always, I mean,
because I don't think when Shane was on there last, I don't remember him saying that they weren't together.
I don't remember him saying anything about her, so I was
sure. Yeah, I don't think they even brought her up.
Yeah.
I guess we'll find out.
Yeah, we'll find out in just 2 months. I cannot believe it. November is just 2 months away. Oh, my gosh. So that was all the new comings and goings that we had. And, of course, in case you didn't know already, Casey Diedrich, Eileen Davidson, and Chandler Massey are both exiting Days. And I believe that Camilla Bannis has confirmed that she will be exiting at the end of her contract come December. As far as we know, the only confirmed recast is Will. Days has and already has found a recast for the role of Will Horton. The Days Studio was dark this past week, and it will be dark this week, but the upcoming the week after, which would be, I'm trying to look at my calendar, I believe the week of September 9th is when Dave goes back into taping, and they will begin taping the January scene, January shows, January 2014, at which time the new Will Horton will begin filming. So I do not believe there will be any break in between Chandler Massey's Will and the new actor Will. We have no idea who the new Will is, but there is a rumor that it is Andy Sunita, and you can look him up on YouTube. He has a he has his video that he his audition tape that he submitted to Dave's, and this is when he auditioned for the role of Ben. That Dave put out a casting call for a few months ago, but rumor has it that he may not be up for Ben, but instead he may be the new Will. So go check him out, type him in on YouTube, Andy Sunita, and check out his tape and see what you think. And remember, please, I know we had a whole show about this last week. If you missed it, please go find us on Blog Talk Radio. Our show from last week is on Blog Talk Radio. Give this new Will a chance. I would say at least 2 months before you judge, because this guy has huge skill. Try to be in his shoes, the new actor. Think of what he's going through, what he knows that he has these huge shoes to fill, and it's not going to be easy. And we can just be patient, have patience. I know it's easier said than done, and I should take my own advice because I'm not a very patient person, but just have patience with this new actor. Like I said, we will not see him until January, so Chandler Massey's will air through the Christmas scene the end of this year. And, of course, we wish Chandler nothing but the best. He made Will his own, and you don't get many young actors like Chandler Massey. So, anyways, major props to Chandler for deciding to continue his education and get that degree, which is ever so important in this day and age. So I think that's all I want to say in the comings and goings. Let me just jump right real quick here into the spoilers for September 2nd. Just in case you all didn't know, which I'm sure you all do, tomorrow is Labor Day, and that is a holiday, and Days will not have a new episode on tomorrow. But the spoilers for the upcoming week. Nicole has a surprising proposal for Marlena. JJ continues to spiral out of control and lands in big trouble. Eric cannot shake his uneasy feelings about the night he got sick at the hotel. And Justin confronts EJ about planting the money in Bernardi's son's account. So, hopefully next week will be a little bit more entertaining than this past week. I'm not saying last week was like the worst shows ever, but I'm just saying I've seen better, I guess is what I'm trying to say.
This week was good for Jennifer Briston and EJ fan.
Yeah, I mean, they were basically on the whole
week,
whole time, every day. Yeah, whole week. We have some fall previews here. I think I'll read just a couple. Let me see what exactly I want to read to you all. Sunny plays matchmaker with Gabby in order to lure her from Nick. And expect to see more of Nick in the fall, but it will not be the nice Nick. And one major spoiler for the fall, and this is the quote, Ken Corday, a high-profile engagement party ends in bloodshed. Da-da-da. So, this is either, I mean, I'm sure we can guess that this is either going to be Briston or EJ. Which is which will be left remain unseen. Who knows? I think I have a pretty good idea of who might be injured. You know, considering on who is leaving the show. But I mean, you never know with days. I mean, it could be someone that we don't even have on our radar. So One last thing that I wanted to bring up. Well, this isn't the last thing, but I just always say that even though it's not the last thing. On Friday's show, Misty, you didn't bring up what Sonny found under the couch.
Oh, yeah.
He was... I mean, I alluded to that. That was a very big part of Friday's show.
So extra like to, large part of Friday's show.
Oh,
how could I leave that out?
So, I mean, basically, Sonny was looking for one of Ariana's toys, I believe, and he was searching the couch for it. You know, he was searching behind the cushions, under the cushions, in the cracks and everything, and he was looking under the couch, and he just happened to find something that was not Ariana's toy, but happened to be a condom, an open condom. And at that point, Gabby had just come out of Ariana's room, and Sonny just had the look of, if looks could kill, basically, is the look that Sonny had. And that is how that ended on Friday. So I'm sure that we'll probably see Will come in on next week, this coming week, and I'm sure he'll have something to say about all of this. So that'll be interesting. let me see. I think that is all I want to say about days last week and upcoming, but here I go again by saying one last thing I'd like to say. I'd just like to bring up, I'd like to say happy birthday to my very good friend Aries, who I run Salem Spectators with on Facebook. So this is a little plug for our page. If you haven't liked this, go to Facebook, type in Salem Spectators. We are a Days of Our Lives fan page where we have role-playing. We have memes and awesome banners that are made by Aries. So check us out if you haven't yet. But very happy birthday to him.
Yay,
me and my friend
birthday.
Dana run the page with him. So wish him a very happy – I haven't heard from him today yet, so I don't know what he's doing. Kind of wondering
he's
where he is. that must be it. He's probably out going crazy.
He's like, oh, it's my birthday. Woo! And he's out there tearing up the clubs. I'm just kidding.
I totally couldn't see him doing that, but I don't know. Maybe he is.
he's making banners.
Hopefully, which he doesn't. If you haven't checked out the banners on Salem Spectators, please go check them out because Aries makes all of them, and they are
awesome.
Just phenomenal.
But if
you go there right now and you see the banner that's up there right now, don't judge because that is the one that I made myself because I couldn't ask Aries to make a banner for himself, so I made one. So,
I like
trust
your banner.
Mine are not as good. Oh, did you thought it was good?
Yeah. It was
I
funny.
Tried.
Someone mentioned where you put his name on Chad's abs. I thought it was funny. But, I mean, you couldn't miss his name there because everybody's going to look there.
Right. I mean, whose eyes wouldn't be drawn to that?
Exactly.
Okay. So, anyway, happy birthday, Aries. I'm not sure if you're listening, but if you listen later, shout out to you. So, I think that's all for tonight's show. I just want to close it out by mentioning finding us on social media. Common Ground, you can find us on Twitter at CG Online Radio, on Facebook at just type in Common Ground there in the search bar or logo as an hourglass, so that should be easy to find. You can find our let's see here. Episode 1 through 13, 1 through 14, because tonight is our 14th episode. You can find those shows here on TalkShoe, but most recently, as you know, we have moved to Blog Talk Radio, and we are now under the Air Nation Radio Network umbrella. So our past three or four, I'm not sure, but they are on Blog Talk Radio. So you can go there and listen to those. If you have trouble finding them, just go to airnationradio.com, and you can find our page. You can find Common Ground Radio on the Air Nation Radio website. There will be links to all of our three or four shows that have been on Blog Talk Radio. You'll also find on the Common Ground Radio page on airnationradio.com, you'll also find my biography as well as Misty's biography in case you're ever hoping to learn a little bit more about the host of the show. So in case you were wondering, tonight was just a one-time thing being on Talk Shoe. We will be continuing to air on the Air Nation Radio umbrella on Blog Talk Radio. So next week we will be back on Blog Talk Radio. And, of course, we will be tweeting the link out all week, so you won't be lost. I know kind of a little back and forth between Talk Shoe and Blog Talk, but like I said, we'll be on Blog Talk Radio next week, and hopefully that's where we'll continue to have all of our live shows Sunday night. So with that being said, the show tonight, by thanking everyone in the chat room for joining us. We hope you had a very good time tonight, and we hope you will join us next week, same time, different place on Blog Talk Radio at 7 Eastern Standard Time. So, for Common Ground Radio, this is Brandon.
I'm Misty.
Have a great day, everyone.
Yay, have a happy Labor Day. Bye.
You've been listening to Common Ground Radio with hosts Brandon and Misty on the Air Nation Radio Network. Thank you for joining us.